Quickly on your Captain America stuff, what happened with you in the WWE? A, is that still potentially someone to come back and aim for? But did you ever go have conversations with them?
Yeah, hugely. So 2013, after the Lions, I met the head of their recruitment. I've always been a lifelong wrestling fan.
Is that Vince, whatever he's called, Vince McMahon?
It's actually a guy called Canyon Seaman at the time. He was an ex-volleyball athlete who basically took over the recruitment side of athlete crossovers specifically for NXT, right, which is WWE's like sort of development territory, the performance center. And this was 2013. It was still a bit in its infancy, them putting together this athlete crossover program. But I met with them. I spoke with him. I'd met Canyon. We'd had a lot of conversations. I'd met him in London as well. When I was in America visiting my family after Lions, he actually met me. They flew me down to Florida, picked me up in a limo, the full nine yards, took me to the performance center there. I got to train, meet the coaches, and they did make me an offer. At the time, I had a contract with Saints that I just was about to start. Not as much I was making in rugby, but really I still felt like I had more to contribute in rugby, and it was kind of like a dream that I maybe needed more time till I got to. And they also, the contracts as well, if you get injured, you can be cut after 30 days, which is, you know, actually makes you grateful for sort of rugby and the protections that we actually had in the sport of the risk of injury. And then as my career got more injured, I didn't want to go full-time into another environment. I did get to do some pro wrestling in, I believe it was 2017 for TNA at the time, which is kind of like the number two. I've been on a pay-per-view cage match. I've wrestled with Bobby Lashley, who's a big star in the US. I've taken chair shots. I took Moose off the top of the cage. I've done a lot of stuff. I did like two stints where we were there for like 4 or 5 days, and they would film like 3 weeks of taping. I was training at American Top Team, doing sort of jiu-jitsu MMA training, and they were doing this American Top Team MMA meets wrestling crossover. And a lot of their guys had fights coming up, and they didn't have people that could fly up to Canada to do the filming. So that the owner of ATT asked me if I'd go with him. They covered all the expenses, and I went out there and lived my childhood dream, and I smashed it around. I took a chair shot to the back that really hurt.
Did it actually hurt?
I took one in the stomach, so then I was laying like flat, and then the guy was cracking it over my back. And the guy is a wrestler called Moose. He played for the Patriots. He's 6'4", big, you know, close to 300 pounds, very athletic. He was like, "Don't worry, man, I'll hit you with it." Like, we talked it through before. He hit me so bloody hard that like my scapulas were dead. Like, I had, you know, you get a dead leg. I had a dead scapula. I was like, I hit the ground, rolled up. In my head, I was like, "Mate, this is killing me. I got to fight him when I get to the back." Like, I don't know what the crack is. And then I came in the back and he's like, "Man, I'm sorry." He's like, "I hate giving those, but I got to make it look real." And, you know, that was probably the thing I did that hurt the most.